The intelligence, so to speak, encoded in machine learning models relies entirely on their ability to learn. Learning, or training, means finding the parameter values that best fit the training data. There are three broad types of training approaches, and they are defined by the training data used. To parse the differences in these approaches, let's use an example: image recognition. Say we're building a model to detect the presence of the letter T in a given image. The input is the image file. The output is a determination, T or no T. The training set would be a bunch of sample pictures. In some cases, we might know whether or not each sample picture contains a T. This is called labeled data. Each input value is labeled with a corresponding output value. Training with labeled data is called supervised training. This is like training with an answer key. For each input value, we can compare the model's predicted output with the answer, the known output. During training, the model parameter values are refined until its predicted outputs match the known outputs as closely as possible. Regressions, like in our earlier store sales model, used supervised learning. Sometimes, however, we don't know the true output for each entry in the training data, and we will need to use the second training approach. Say we have sample images, but we don't know in advance if they contain the letter T. Labeling this data would be a time-intensive and costly task. Humans would need to review each picture to make a T or no T determination. Incidentally, this is exactly the manual process you're contributing to when you identify all the stoplights or buses while logging in. Your answers are helping label the images in a training data set, which can then be used to train, via supervised learning, image recognition models, like those used by self-driving cars. Sometimes, the absence of labeled data is not about feasibility, it's about the nature of the problem. The outputs simply cannot be known in advance. A customer segmentation model is a good example. The point of the model is to sort customer profiles into similar groups, based on patterns the model detects. The outputs, the assigned segments, are only known after the model is trained. This type of approach is called clustering. Training with unlabeled data is called unsupervised learning. In other cases, you simply don't have much initial training data at all. The best way to train a model is via the third approach: give it iterative feedback. For example, say you're training an AI model to be competitive at a game like chess. When the AI wins a game, you can reward it, encouraging it to repeat whatever it did in that game. When it loses, you can do the opposite. Practice makes perfect, as they say. This is exactly the approach taken by AlphaGo, an AI model trained by Google that beat the world's best player of the board game Go in 2016. This third training approach is called reinforcement training, or RL. Self-driving cars also use RL. When the car maneuvers successfully, a reward is applied. When it moves dangerously, a penalty. In some cases, RL gets its feedback directly from human users. This is called RLHF, for reinforcement learning from human feedback. RLHF can be used in our T-no-T model. Instead of training it upfront via supervised learning, it could be trained slowly via reinforcement. The model makes a guess, a human gives it feedback, and it adjusts. On the surface, the difference between RL and supervised learning in this case appears to be a matter of timing. Train it upfront or slowly over time. However, underneath the hood, very different algorithms would be used for RL versus supervised learning. In practice, an AI model might be trained via a combination of these three approaches. For example, large language models, like the one behind ChatGPT, are trained in two steps: pre-training and then fine-tuning. Pre-training relies heavily on unsupervised learning. The model learns to find and learns to repeat patterns in language by training on large swaths of unlabeled text. The P in GPT? That's pre-trained. Two down, one to go. During fine-tuning, supervised learning can train the model on more specific tasks, like sentiment analysis. By labeling sample text as either friendly tone or irritated tone, for example, developers can train the model to detect and replicate specific sentiments. Fine-tuning will also commonly make use of RLHF. This is what happens when ChatGPT asks you which of two alternative responses you found most helpful.